I'm your host, Rob French. Welcome back to Rob's Arcade.
Safe, so they can be playing on another day. Rob's Arcade.
What does that mean?
Is that NSYNC?
Yeah. So if you touch it, then NSYNC goes in the
backseat.
Like the band.
The actual band.
Well, good morning, guys, and welcome back to Rob's Arcade. Of course, I'm Rob French, your host. And actually, we're stepping out of Rob's Arcade today and heading to Disney World's Epcot to hang out, ride some rides, eat some more food at the Food and Wine Fest. Got it. Which I'm excited for because I haven't really ridden any rides. We've been a couple of times. I don't feel like I've ridden anything since we've been. It's been mostly about Food and Wine. But there's also, I think, some new booths open today that weren't open the last time we did Food and Wine.
In 1.1 miles, turn left onto West
Bay
on Crescent and Boulevard.
Right. That they weren't open the last time we went. So it's new food. To the Ratatouille for breakfast, right? The Ratatouille?
No.
Where are we going?
We're in the Steakhouse 71.
Steakhouse 71 for breakfast. Just dye her hair red, it's really pretty.
Too.
Breakfast reservations.
You have reservations where?
At Steakhouse 71.
Okay, last name?
O'Grady.
O'Grady. First name?
Carrie Ann.
You got it.
Thank
you. Guys,
you
have a great time.
Thank you.
And to the left.
Thank you.
Section here.
Yeah. I wish they had the parks one. I would actually probably buy it, even though it's like $230. And then look.
Was that the popcorn one?
Yeah, to match my ears.
Does it smell like popcorn too?
I don't know. I can't smell it. I got a mask on though.
It smells like a mask?
Really cute.
Which one, the Marvel?
No,
the Marvel.
Just relax.
Oh, I like the pillows. These are cool. What are they listed yet?
for Christmas.
Those are pretty cool.
Just later. You have some in
kind of cool. And who is it? Zorg?
Zurg.
I was just thinking these would have been fun for when I did my costume. I could have had my little Woody and Buzz and blown them up.
Let's head downstairs, okay?
Okay. Then you show these people, I guess, your thing.
Well, here we are, everybody, at the beautiful Walt Disney's Epcot. Now, this is one of my favorite parks in terms of theme. It's right up there with the Animal Kingdom. And though I do enjoy the classic cinema and the movie-making themes of Hollywood Studios, to me, no other park better defines what Walt Disney set out to do when he originally opened Walt Disney World back in 1971. And that is to remind us that even though we all come from very different backgrounds, different cultures, and we are different people, we do share one Earth. And in my opinion, no other park better epitomizes that than Epcot, which, ironically, opened this month back in 1982. So, do me a favor, take a trip with my wife and I as we take a tour around the world through the eyes of Mr. Walt Disney himself. Let's go, guys.
Thank you. I enjoy classy things. It really has a signature style to it.
If my car was an instrument, it'd be a tuba or a contra. You could put the windshield the right over into the bell, it's and you would sit there and chat with it.
My car would look like an alligator and have a shoulder tie. It's kind of looking nice, kind of thin, like it has the stars on it and like the more worn out.
My driving car would probably be sort of like a pickup truck, but have sort of like nails on the side and the windows are sort of slanted so it looks like eyes. That's what I was thinking. Red stripes, like exactly what I was thinking.
Which one is, and then yeah, I guess you hit that.
Capability test to see how your vehicle designs perform under challenging weather and surface conditions.
Monitoring road surface. connecting to OnStar. SIM card performance data acquired.
Let's see how your designs hold up now.
Commencing SimCar off-road and extreme weather sequence. Capability test results displayed and verified.
Now let's see how your vehicles compare when it comes to their efficiency.
Scanning SimCar for optimal eco efficiency. Engaging EcoScan for aerodynamic efficiency. Drive systems analysis. Hyperspectral imaging in progress. Calculating total enviro impact. Commencing responsiveness test.
Okay, the responsiveness data is now being synchronized.
Automated driving technology verified and active. Avoidance technology disengaged. Displaying responsiveness data.
Here comes the final test.
Energizing for power test.
the surface of the land, roots trap water from the flowing mud, extracting precious nutrients and minerals. These elements, when combined with sunlight, create the first living systems of our planet, providing us with oxygen, food, medicine, and other elements essential to our lives. Alive. The plants and animals that have learned to survive in these harsh conditions make use of what little water they can find and avoid the scorching rays of the relentless sun. But over time, rainwater and nutrients gradually penetrated the hard surface of this land. Even the hooves of the mighty buffalo helped create the rich soil that would one day become home to the American farm. How will we meet tomorrow's growing needs for food production, yet still respect the needs of the land? Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future. The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions.
Oh, hey, Mickey.
Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. But fish farming, or aquaculture, accounts for nearly half of all the species of tilapia, bass, and catfish, like the ones you see here, are part of the more tropical crops raised by fish farmers. The sustainable system we're using here recycles the water in the tanks. As a result, we're able to save millions of gallons each year. Our global fish farms produce nearly 5,000 pounds of fish each year to serve as restaurants around Walt Disney World. The common grains growing here, wheat, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. These plants are definitely on their way up. Innovative growing techniques like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Another innovation at work here is our integrated pest management program. By populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests, like aphids and flies, we are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing these crops using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area. Some of our best ideas have been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these ground plants vertically,
we can increase yield and better control diseases. These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we serve more than 15 tons of produce from our greenhouses in restaurants here at the land every year.
Okay, well, apparently Test Track was having some issues, so we opted for coffee instead. Either way, zoom, zoom, zoom.
Make a heart go boom, boom, my supernova.